In this video, you will learn the high-level steps for deploying DLP for cloud email with Microsoft 365. To configure DLP for cloud email with Microsoft 365, you need to perform the following tasks. Enable DKIM signing for outbound mail. Configure email settings in the Force.1 data security portal. Configure Microsoft Defender to allow messages from the Force.1 cloud. Configure connectors in Exchange to route traffic to and from the Force.1 cloud. And configure transport rules in Exchange to submit mail for scanning and process scanned emails. Let's take a look at these tasks in more detail. To start, ensure you have DKIM signing enabled for your outbound mail. The Force.1 MTA will reject email that doesn't contain a DKIM signature or that fails DKIM verification. Now sign in to the Force.1 data security portal and configure the email settings. Set the vendor to Office 365. Add your email domains. Force.1 will only accept email address from domains in this list. Lastly, configure the Smart Host MTA. This is where Force.1 will deliver emails once they have been scanned by DPS. Typically, this will be the host name of your Exchange server. Now move on to the Microsoft 365 settings. Start by configuring Microsoft Defender to always allow messages from the Force.1 cloud. Sign in to Microsoft Defender and navigate to Email and Collaboration, Policies and Rules, Threat Policies, Anti-Spam. On the Anti-Spam Policies page, select Connection Filter Policy, Default. Edit the Connection Filter Policy and add the Force.1 DLP for cloud email IPs to the IP Allow list. Then save the changes. You are now ready to configure mail flow rules in Exchange. Sign in to the Exchange Admin Center and navigate to Mail Flow Connectors. In the Exchange Admin Center, you'll need to configure connectors and transport rules. Create an outbound connector to route outbound mail to the Force.1 cloud for scanning. Configure the connector to only be used when a transport rule routes messages to the connector. You'll configure that rule as your last deployment step. Enter the host name provided by Force.1 for your tenant. You can then send a validation email to test the connection. Next, create an inbound connector to receive scanned mail back from the Force.1 cloud. Set connection from to your organization's email server and the connection to as Office 365. Set the authenticating sent email setting to verify the IP address and enter the IP addresses for the Force.1 cloud service. Next, create transport rules to apply an action to messages that have been scanned by Force.1. The rules evaluate the scan result in the X-Force.1 DLP email header and perform an action based on the header value. For example, you could create a single rule to block mail with any Force.1 DLPX header value other than DLP accept. Alternatively, you could create two rules, one to block messages that match DLP policies and a second to forward messages for approval if DLP scanning errors occur. You do not need to create a rule for the DLP accept X header value. Messages that do not match a rule will be queued for delivery to the recipient mail server. Finally, create a transport rule for your outbound connector to route mail to Force.1 cloud for scanning. Configure the rule to apply to outbound mail and add an exception for messages containing the Force.1 X header. This is to prevent messages that have already been scanned from looping. Once you enable the transport rule, your outbound mail will be routed to the ForcePoint cloud and scanned against your configured DLP policies. Your outbound email is now protected by ForcePoint DLP for cloud email